Our next speaker is retired Chief Parole Officer Jeff Perry, and he's going to talk to you about how to protect your home. Take it away, Jeff. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jeff Perry. Just want to give a little background experience right here, that you know who you're talking to. I have a Bachelor of Science degree in Criminal Justice from Georgia Southern College. I also completed my Master's degree from the University of North Georgia. I completed the Certified Public Managers Program from the Carl Benson Institute at UGA. I've been a Chief Parole Officer for 19 years and a Parole Officer for 26. Intern with the Statesboro Police Department for 2 years, and like Jeff, I'm a post-certified firearms instructor, and I've been doing that for 20 years. Numerous hours of law enforcement training, supervisor of G8 Summit, the World Leaders, State Olympic Law Enforcement Command. My wife is here, Lisa Fisher and Perry, so we've been married for 27 years. We have two adult children, the memberships in Rotary Club, Civitan, JC, Sigma Nu Fraternity, Republican Party, NRA, and the Georgia Sheriff Association. I'm a deacon at Liberty Baptist Church, where I currently serve as the vice chairman. I've been a Boy Scout leader here in your community, park and rec coach in those sports, and Dawson County resident for 26 years. Talk about the topic is how to protect your home, but they threw me a loop, how to protect your home without a gun. So, that, you know, one of the first things I'm going to say, I'm going to be like Jeff, get a gun, learn how to use a gun, but for those people that don't have a gun, this is what we're going to do, tell you how to do it. In 2014, there was estimated 1.7 million burglaries, but that's a decrease of 10.5% when compared to the 2013 data. Number of burglaries decreased 20.2% compared with 2010, and it was down 19.7% when you look at a 10-year time period, which is, that's good news. The estimated number of burglaries account for 20.9% of the estimated number of property crimes. And if you go by subject category, and this comes from the, everybody can have access to this, it comes from the FBI Uniform Crime Report, or referred to as UCR, the FBI puts it out every year on all types of crimes. So if you look at that, burglaries of residential properties accounted for 73.2% of burglary, which means you're likely to be burglarized at your home as opposed to your business. Home safety tips. Again, right here you see, purchase a firearm and learn how to use it properly. So let's say you don't have that, and Frank and him hit on some couple good choices early on. Pepper spray, taser, batons, clubs, stun guns, knives, self-defense, a hammer, anything that you get into your hands on, a frying pan that will do damage. Wall spray is really good. Try that. Try to spray someone in the eyes with wall spray and see what happens. Also consider installing a monitor security system at your home. I had a friend of mine, he got his home was burglarized. Got all his guns, so he goes out the next day and buys a monitoring system. He's had it for 10 years and hasn't been burglarized. So, you know, I don't know if those two go together or what. Don't put, this is what we all like to do. When we go on vacation, we like to post pictures of the beach and where we at, and we'll be back home in 10 days. Don't do that, because criminals, they have access to the web, and they're very active in that. So when traveling, always tell a trusted neighbor that you're going out of town. And they can stop over, pick up your mail, and look over things or whatever. So that's a good idea. Turn down the volume on your answering machine. That was something I wasn't aware of. So when they call, they can't hear that this is recording. This is recording very low, so they can't differentiate between when someone's home and when someone is not. Use visual deterrents such as a beware of dogs. So you don't even have to have a dog or a security system, but you can get those signs. I had one guy that when it had something, when he knocked on his door, you hear this big, ferocious dog. It was just a recording of a dog. So nobody was going to go in there. And if you live in a cold climate, make sure to clear sidewalks and a driveway. Landscaping is also a deterrent, meaning you can put these thorny bushes outside your window and some that grow real. Don't trim your hedges, and they're hard to get into your home. Never leave notes on your door for service people. That's a big one. Like, you know, you're going to be gone for a couple of days, or working late, you put a sign on there and say, I'm going to be home till 10 o'clock tomorrow. Just leave the package. But that's a big giveaway right here. So these are all great tips right here. Let me move right along over on the time schedule. Here's some other ones. If your front entrance contains decorative glass or open glass, and you got your home security system in a hallway, when you're looking in there, what can they see? They can see the home security system. So, and if it's like, here's a really neat one too. A lot of times when we come home, we put our keys out, we put them in a key basket, hang them on a key thing. Put this key fob right here on your nightstand, because what you have an alarm. Here's mine going on. So that's a real good, keep it right there. Noise and distractions scare people away for something, right? You store your valuables in your closet or in your drawers. That's where the first thing criminals want to go to when they go in, your drawers. Put them in your kids' sock drawer. You know, they don't think kids have a lot of valuables, and so they won't spend very little time in the kids' room. If you don't, and that's another one on the sign. If you don't have a security system, purchase a decal. Or if you go to somebody's house and they got a security system, say, hey, can you get me a decal? And so you get the best of both worlds right here. Join a community-wide crime prevention program. This is one of the biggest tips right here. Become a member of a neighborhood watch. And that's what we're going to touch on there at the very end. Always check out through a peephole or women before opening your door. Keep your doors closed even when you're home, including a lot of times we have a screen or a storm door. We leave our other door open and forget to latch our storm door, which you just open and you go right in. Garage doors up. Keep blinds and curtains closed so you don't advertise what's inside. You know, somebody's walking by and they see a wooden gun cabinet right there, not a gun safe, and they see all these guns in there, then you're going to be a high risk, high target. Request identification if a stranger claims to be a police officer or other government official. And this is when you're at a hotel too. I think Frank talked about that. Sometimes somebody come up and say, I'm with hotel security. First off, open up. Call down to the front desk and see if they sent someone up. Get a dog. If you don't have a dog, get a cat, but get a lion or a tiger. Here's some stats right here. Where to break in the curve. Front door 30% of the time. Makes sense. Sometimes we don't even lock our front doors. 23% of break-ins on the first floor windows, which is a little bit easier access than the second floor. Side entry 22%, because sometimes we forget about that. We go in and out of the side door so often we don't lock it. We lock a front door and we lock our garage door. Garage 9%, basement 4%, and second floor 2%. Which there was a tip in there also. Don't put stacked firewood or put ladders around your house, because what you do, and that was like the Lindbergh kidnapping. I mean, they brought a ladder, but if you keep logs and you keep ladders around them, it's just easy access. I got 2 minutes. Okay. This is what I want to talk about. Real quick, neighborhood watch program. If you don't have, if you live in a community, if you live in a subdivision, make sure you get together and form a neighborhood watch program. When we live in a transient society today, where either both parents work, people come in and out, people move, we don't know our neighbors. If you become a part of a neighborhood watch program, you get to know your neighbors. You get to, it's just someone looking out for someone else. And the good thing about this, if I'm elected sheriff, we would enhance the neighborhood watch programs we have. We would strengthen these neighborhood watch programs by giving you training on what to look for, how to even start a neighborhood watch program. Who can be involved. Anyone can be involved. If you have a community, if you have some houses, get together. Elect a block captain or a neighborhood watch captain. Can I live in an apartment? If anyone lives in an apartment building here, yes, you can start a neighborhood watch program. What are my responsibilities as a watch member? Be alert, know your neighbors, and watch out for each other. Right? I'm having to go right now because I'm out of time, but I have this right here. I have some brochures up here, and it has my my email address. If you will send me your email address and say you want a copy of this PowerPoint presentation, I will send you a copy. But it's very, has a lot of great information on that. Any questions?
Oh, can I make a short comment? We actually had a bunch of robbery at our house because the second it happened, you know, when we were calling all the neighbors down the street, called the first one, oh yeah, I remember seeing that car by your house. Like, no, nobody said a word. But this is how politically correct our society is now. Nobody says a word. Mm-hmm. I call the next neighbor, oh, that's right, you know, saw the car. You know, they're just, they're casing the place. And nobody said a word. I called this other place and said, oh yeah, they were actually knocking on their door to see if they were home. He actually called the police department and said the police hadn't, you know, made it, called them back about it and stuff like that. So when we see something suspicious, call. I mean, there were multiple times where I just see a strange vehicle. So I work late, coming home at 11 o'clock at night, and somebody's sitting in my neighborhood just in the middle, you know, beginning of the road. I'm calling 911. This is the second time I've seen it. I mean, send somebody out.
Good idea. So we see stuff. Lost the stack number two.
It's certainly very correct. I mean, a lot of times we see something, but we don't want to get involved, or maybe we don't want to report it because they may retaliate against us or be politically incorrect. That's what happened in California with the terrorist shootings there. Neighbors saw those, saw the guy across the street in his garage, and people coming and going all different nights. But they didn't want to impose, or they didn't want to seem politically incorrect about that. So stay informed. If you see something, report it.
I actually have a question. If you start a neighborhood watch, can you, we used to live in a neighborhood in Warner Robins where we started one, and we actually got a sign that said in neighborhood watch, like neighborhood.
Yeah.
Can we do that here in Dawson County?
You can. And I've seen, I think, Chesapeake, I think they have a neighborhood watch program. But yeah, you can. One thing that, we would put together a program to train anyone about how to start a neighborhood watch program, what to look for, give you some numbers and contacts, and still just getting together with 10, 7, 8 people, say we want to start a neighborhood watch program. It's good, it's better to be informed and trained in what to look for and how to start a neighborhood watch program.
I was going to say, one day, this car pulled up in front of my house and he just sat there. And it appeared it was a workman, and then he was writing stuff down. But I went out and took his picture. Yeah. I thought, well, you know, exactly. It turns out something bad happened. I caught his picture.
Yeah, well, everybody's taking pictures now with cell phones. I mean, it's so much harder to do your job now. You're seeing the blowback that law enforcement officers across the country are having. So, yeah, I mean, take their picture because someone's going to be taking your picture. You can believe that. All right, thank you all.
Good evening.